Hello and welcome back to Good Game Nation, where we bring you all things TCG. My name is Preston. I'm here with Sam. Say hello.
Hello. We're back to Fight Nights, doing them more regularly, and we're bringing you different set three leaders.
Yeah, we're having fun with set three, testing stuff out and preparing for just what's going to happen next.
Yeah.
We're gonna have to really be into it at some point, so it's good to start thinking about it now.
You know, I feel like I didn't play a lot of set two, but I want to get better at set three.
Mm-hmm.
Lost your camera, buddy.
I know. It'll be back.
I believe you.
Turn one. Deploy.
We played Nami and Katakuri last time, and as the Nami player, I did make some mistakes, but that match is incredibly, incredibly difficult. I know I read some tweets of some other players talking about that matchup, and oh, we got something. We got life. They talked about it, and I knew that matchup was unfavorable, but I didn't realize how much. But it's a good learning experience. I did like how Katakuri looked. It looked very well.
Yeah, Katakuri seems really fun. It's unfortunate that they rolled for webcams so poorly, I think. Right. Where you basically give your opponent game knowledge. Which isn't great.
Yeah.
But
yeah. That just happened. If you guys didn't see that, maybe we'll link that down below. I saw a couple tweets. I'll try to find the official page. But they said Katakuri will let you give both players the game knowledge when you view your opponent's top life. Mm-hmm. That's unfortunate. But it's just for webcams. So hopefully, probably just means we'll see less Katakuris in webcams, probably, which is unfortunate. It's a good deck, though, especially in set four. It's seeing a lot of hype.
It's really unfortunate because, yeah, that means I don't want to play it on regionals and stuff like that.
Right. Right, exactly.
But, yeah, that should have been in the news, and I don't know. It's interesting. It's unfortunate, but when you have to cater to webcam tournaments, which are great, it gives you access to promos and stuff. You have to have something for this. Like, either you say you ignore the fact that you're you completely ignore the fact that your opponent's going to most likely be looking at their webcam also,
right?
Or you address it and say, oh, we'll just give them the game knowledge.
It's too bad we can't use sim in a or something like this. That would be great. Yeah. I agree.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Batsu got most of the bugs out for everything up to this point, so.
It's just user error, honestly. I'm just terrible. That's the real issue, is I'm no using it. I'm using it. That's the real issue.
Yeah.
That's so unfortunate.
This is a hard matchup for me.
Yes, and I think this is. I think it comes down to how Marco does. Oh. Man. Set 3 has a lot of cool decks. I know it was primarily dominated by red in the east. Zoro Whitebeard primarily, but I feel like we saw a lot of other decks do well in the medium. Well, if that makes sense, like Katakuri, Ace, Lucci, Nami, they were fighting for a lot of like 8 through 16s, and I was seeing them more and more towards the end. It was nice. Hoping we see that here in the West. No blocker.
Decks are so much. I have to pay attention to what's going up and down, so I can.
Honestly, take your time. I'm the one that makes the mistakes. I need to start doing that.
Well, I searched so much when we were practicing that I knew about what was coming through my deck because it cycled so much.
Right, right.
So, like, placing the cards at the bottom, in some decks, doesn't matter. You just throw it at the bottom. You're never going to dig that deep. This deck can dig through your deck a couple times just because Striker's going to grab one every turn.
Mm-hmm. 6K. Say Striker's been a card that I liked when I was testing it. I'm a pretty big fan of that one. Especially towards the end game, it gets really, really beneficial.
Yeah, it's really interesting to, for two cost, get a, at least a minimum of a 1K counter to your hand.
Just need all the stages to be like this, like somewhat more beneficial. All stadiums are not created equal.
No.
Yeah, get him, Lucci. Yeah. Tiger Man. Hope we see them more in the manga. No spoilers, sorry. But no spoilers, but I just hope I see them more. How many cards do you have in your hand? What is this? This is ridiculous. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11? That's ridiculous.
I also haven't been playing a lot of cards, so it's not too crazy.
Hmm.
What are we at? Yeah.
Does set three come this weekend or is it next weekend? Soon, right?
It's soon. Pre-releases, I think, start the 23rd, so probably the day this comes out.
This comes out, yeah. I was about to say. Man. So
pre-releases start next week to us.
Right.
Recording this a little early. I don't know what to do. It's annoying to deal with 7Ks and stuff that I can't KO by card effect.
What do you mean one card effect?
What?
You mean not, you, there's not a one direct answer to the one card? Is that what you meant?
No, I can't KO Borsellino by card effects, right?
No, that's a great effect. We should leave that effect.
It's hard for me to deal with that. Mm. And then you have a 7K on board, which is hard for me to KO without extreme measures. So I just don't know what to play into. It's fun. I had a decent hand, I felt like, at the beginning, too. And now I just... I'm not playing it well, I think.
Ace is tough. I think matchup to matchup, Ace is a very hard leader to play. He at least takes rhythm with the deck because he plays way different than all the other ones. So I definitely think he takes some repetition. Definitely not as much as Law, but up there. That's a thinking man right there.
It's not a good play.
Oh, that's a bummer.
I needed to get rid of stuff. I wanted to kind of do that next turn, but.
I didn't like that. You have so many cards too.
They're all 1K counters. It's interesting. Ace is difficult. And the way that we build it, I'm pretty sure we'll have the deck list in the description, is you play a heavy amount of events because you can use them like that. Yeah. And which leads you with being very choosy about how you play your characters. And putting yourself in a position where you can't clear board easily because you have to defend differently. So it's interesting. I don't know if it's my speed yet, but it's definitely fun to play it differently. Oof. Nice.
Ooh, I got a Marco and a Seaquake. Nice. Nice.
Scary.
Beautiful looking card.
Let's see. What does this do?
Yeah, black becomes very interesting in this next meta. Especially since Smoker got a lot of play, way more than it did in the East. I imagine we're going to see a hefty number of Luchis.
Mm-hmm.
Which is good.
And we might just see a lot of Smokers still.
I expect to see a lot of Smokers still, yeah. He's a favorite out here.
He really is.
Him, Dofi, Magellan, they're around. Didn't think he plays that turn.
I guess that makes sense.
To save him or to not save him, that is the question. It gets so interesting. Oh. Interesting. Bummer. I guess he was dying.
Yeah, you made me do this.
You just gaslit me into that. That's definitely my fault. You're right. I deserve that.
I didn't want to do that.
Yeah, I forced your hand, apparently. Yeah, you seem real torn up about it.
That's so funny.
Radical beam off striker. Okay. That's annoying.
Late game radical beam's fun.
What does one do?
Scoop.
Is that the play?
You got nothing good going for you. You don't have a monster on the board with all your Dawn open.
There it is. It's a 7 to leader. Okay.
Cool. Yikes.
That's just crazy. One life.
No, it's the Sakazuki that gets you played. That's the
the
painful one.
Just start playing all the admirals. I don't play any CP characters. It's just admirals.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So out of all the reds you've played, I think you've played most versions. Probably the least was Whitebeard. Out of the red, which ones would you say are your favorites? Just to play, not necessarily the best.
The cheesiest is Low Zoro, because it just isn't fun for your opponent.
But it's fun for
you? It's like, it's okay. At best, it's okay. You just have answers for a lot of things. You should have enough answers on this side for right. this deck also, but you just end up having options, so you get to do a lot with it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're playing low-cost characters that end up being big at the end, so... Or big enough to be annoying. So it feels like you're doing a lot. So it's probably that one, just because you get to feel like you're playing the game.
Mm.
This has potential. I just need to figure out what plays are optimal when and work around that.
Fair.
I have to work around an Aisho. Fix Dawn to get an attack on him. That stinks. Yeah, because it doesn't let me establish board presence at all. Okay. Oh, I can do this. I can do this. I'm silly. Do that. Do it all at once.
11. That was interesting. I wonder what leader I'm going to play next. What else came out this set? What purple leader is this again? Oh, this is,
Iceberg.
I'll absolutely play Iceberg next. That sounds like a great time. Ooh, Flame Emperor. Fancy.
So
Flame Emperor is a tool of removal.
Yeah. I could KO the Sakazuki, and then with my attack, you block it with one of your blockers.
I might draw two life. Oh.
I guess you're ahead enough.
Babe.
Yeah. Leaves me with one Dawn open. That's the bad part for me.
Right. That makes sense.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, I really talked you into that one.
Yeah, block it or not, I at least get rid of an attacker. No, cancel effect.
Kinda wanna see what I get. Those are pretty interesting cards.
Ace is difficult. It's a much more heady deck than I expected. I have to be really considerate. And I'm trying to think of ways to KO your stuff, and my KOs don't work very well. That sucks. That really sucks.
Something we talked about off camera. We played a couple matches, and we didn't see much of our Markros or Aishos. I saw two this time.
That was unfortunate.
Yeah. I do 8 so I can get around guard point, baby. God, I hope guard points the card in his hand right now. That'd be funny.
It is. Of course it is. Alright. This is a downhill battle for me now. So let's search up another event card.
A lot of movement in this deck. Probably the thing I like most about it. That.
That doesn't matter. Flame Emperor KOs the Bluno. Bluno brings out the CP Kumadori. It's not good.
Got a Tomet. Flame Emperor into it, Aisha would have been so cool though.
Yeah, I know. Now I don't have enough Dawn for that. And waiting is too much time. That's 128 on. Yeah. All right. Wrap it up. I got nothing. That was rough. I have to keep practicing with him.
Practice makes perfect.
Yeah, so. That was probably not the... That was the worst of the choices I could do. Ugh. Gross.
Did I do this incorrectly? Maybe. Is it too late to walk it back? Absolutely.
Hmm.
Yada. It's probably not incorrect math. I did that horribly, but it's okay, hopefully. It might not be okay.
My last life was a buggy, which is really unfortunate because I had switched out buggies for guard points. And if I would have had another guard point, it would have been not enough still.
I was waiting for you to do the math and be like, oh, it's not.
Still not enough. But it would have been more interesting.
It would have been more interesting.
It's really hard. I was holding the Marcos trying to find a good time to play it to be advantageous, and then the Aisho took it, which sucked.
One Aisho is bad, but two is just outright devastating. And I got it off the life I took, and I was like, ooh, that's going to sting. And I saw your hand. It was six. I'm like, ooh, he's going to be upset about this one.
Yeah, that's the thing, too, is I looked, and I was like, all right, I'm at six, but we already got one. What's the chances?
Yeah.
Very high, apparently.
Saw zero in the first two practice matches, two on camera. Camera's buff activated. Let's go.
I was down to 24 cards in my deck, too. That's how much drawing I had. That's 8 cards less than you.
Nami would be proud. But that's the end of this Fight Night match. Let us know in the comments what you guys thought. Let us know about all of our misplays. We love hearing about them. We really love it. It's
a learning experience for me. Tell me how you would play this differently, because I did not play Ace well this time.
I think this is also a pretty difficult matchup. You definitely want cards in your hand, and Aisho is... Mm-hmm. He's good at taking them. It's what he does.
Yeah, he hit an event card too, so that's a easy 1K save.
You know? A lot of value in that Ace deck, but let us know if you want to see round two or what else we should be playing in the next series. And if you are still here, consider doing the YouTube things. Like, comment, subscribe, and we will see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. 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 I watched this creepy podcast where he signs off like really creepy. I want to start trying that. I'd be like, and I'll see you behind you. Bye-bye. Probably not a good idea, but...
I'm in your room.
Yeah. I'll see you at dinner.